I'm Seamus Murphy. I'm a photographer and filmmaker, and I've been traveling to Afghanistan since 1994. These are the Northern Alliance forces entering Kabul November 13, 2001. This is in the wake of 9/11 and then the U.S. Airstrikes on Taliban front lines and Kabul to weaken the regime. This was the National Museum in West Kabul, and I found this drawer full of artifacts and images that had been torn and confiscated by the Taliban. They think the depiction of the human face is idolatrous, and so they're against all that. And there are pictures in there of Jesus, pictures of women, pictures of faces in general that have been torn up. And I found this particular picture, and this woman was actually working in the museum, and I thought it might make a nice composition to put the two together. This shot is in Kabul International Airport, and it's three women in burqas about to get on the plane. And what's interesting is you'll have women in burqas getting onto these planes, flying to other countries, and then as soon as they get on the plane, the burqa comes off, and they're applying makeup, and they get out in Delhi or wherever it is, Dubai. So it's part of the complexity of life in Afghanistan. This was taken in 2004. This is these kids have been working in the fields all day, very hot summer's day, and there's a well, there's a spring that's spouting water, and people are sort of taking a shower and cooling down at the end of the day. What I love about this picture is the boy and the girl, because you know, very soon she's going to be covered up. She's at an age where she's sort of on the cusp of being a woman, and you know, they're enjoying themselves. They're probably great friends, and I suppose to outsiders we see this as the end of her life, or in some way, you know, this is things will change dramatically for her. I mean, I wonder how she feels. This shot is for me it's a great reminder of Afghans, and especially Afghan men, and how they love flowers. They love flowers and birds. And it's not uncommon to see an Afghan man going for a stroll with a flower in his hand. They have a very interesting aesthetic, and you know, they're very interested in poetry and nature and colors and smells. And there's a fruit that men buy, which is the only reason they buy the fruit is because it looks interesting. You know, it doesn't actually smell that interesting. It doesn't taste that interesting. You can't even eat it, but it looks nice. It's got nice patterns on it, and you'll see people buying this fruit just for that. This is a strange picture. I was in central Kabul, very deliberately looking for images to try to go with the Landai poems, the Pashtun poetry, and I was trying to get some sense of a woman's interior life, you know, her private life. You know, she writes in the Landai poems, they write quite shockingly and openly about intimate things and things, you know, very private matters. So I was trying to find images to illustrate that, which is very difficult because it's a very masculine environment, and you don't see a lot of images of, you know, sensuality around in on the streets or you know, in, you know, on the buildings. This lady walking with a knife, I saw her, it was in the bazaar in the old city, and I used to go down there in the evenings and just wander around with the camera and try and pick up some of the atmosphere and, you know, some of what was going on. And this woman was striding along with a knife. She looks like she's got murder in her mind. She really looks like she's going to kill somebody. I don't think she was planning to do that. I think she was determined to get home, and she bought this knife. Or maybe she was doing something else. I don't know. All I know is that I saw it. I took the photograph, and I think quite soon afterwards she put the knife away. So it was one of those grab moments that I think only photography can really capture.